welcome back. Yes, this is the very, very, very first video in the studio. It's quite exciting. I have had some technical issues, I must admit, so the video's coming out rather late. And there's a few other things to think about, like, you know, apps like this. But, you know, it's all. So, without ado, this week we're going to have a look at my naughty week 3. So, let's take a look. So week 3, which for me is always a little bit of a worry because it is birthday week. And birthday week, we tend to indulge a little bit. I'm not really using this as a diet, so the option or the ability of indulging is quite tempting, you know, as we've seen in the other 2 weeks. But around these temptations and around being naughty, we are using the habits from the book to see if that can control the weight. Weeks 1 and 2. I have been using the liver tonic in the evening. So on week 3, it's the first week that you don't have the liver tonic. And also on week 3, you are entitled to a treat day, you know, a relaxed day. Eat what you want day and don't worry about the calories. Keep going up with the core habits, but, you know, count the calories. That's what we are learning to do. But, you know, if you don't want to do that, you don't need to do that. Eat with the habits, relax and chill. So what we have to do now is have a look at the spreadsheet to see where we was up to from week 2. So looking at the spreadsheet from last week, we was at £265, which was another decrease of £4, which is very, very good. Our target was 267, so we're actually under the target. But what we have to do, and the first thing that we have to do every week, is take the 265 number and put it into the spreadsheet, which was calories. Okay, so going back to the MR spreadsheet, 269, which you simply have to change to 265. By doing that, it gives us a calorie count, 1761 calories, which is our daily target. And this daily target for this week applies for 6 days. Like I say, you have a treat day, which I'll probably take as Tuesday. I don't know why, I just fancy a random day, so we'll go for Tuesday. But it's 1761 calories Monday, Wednesday through to Sunday. The maximum, minimum is obviously 1200. And Tuesday, we can eat as many as we want. So, there we go. But the big question is, as always, what did I eat? As I said at the start of the video, my birthday is actually next week on the 15th of April. However, it's birthday week. What I mean by that is it's quite traditional to get the bacon buses in at work. And also we have other people that I work with, it's also their birthday. They've actually arranged to go out for a buffet on a Friday. Now, if anybody knows me, anybody would know I absolutely adore buffet. But I'll try and be good. And obviously, me booking the plan, quite suppressed. You don't crave as much food generally, just as a natural way of things. So let's have a look to see what we had. So starting with Monday, and being naughty, I skipped breakfast. I also skipped morning snack. What I did have was vegetable curry with cauliflower rice, something that I've made at home. And cauliflower rice is not a bad substitute for normal rice. It's less in calories, but it's quite a good choice. That was followed in the afternoon by flame grilled chips, which is just a big packet. Amazingly, one packet can be up to 250 calories. So you've got to be careful with these type of crisps. Almost double to, say, Walker's cheese and onion or something like that. But that was the afternoon snack. And then in the evening, it was pot noodle, chicken and mushroom, and with bread. So once again, the plan says don't eat bread. You're being naughty. So in the evening, a couple of gin and tonics to relax with while watching TV. That actually came to 1,347 calories. So we're all on Tuesday, and once again we're being naughty. So we've got to skip the breakfast, we've got to not bother with the morning snack. Get to lunchtime, and got a minestrone soup from the restaurant, which was really light, lots of pasta. A lot of pasta in a tomato sauce. And followed by corned beef hash, which once again I've made at home, so following kind of in the kitchen. Methodology. And then I didn't have any snacks in the afternoon. That passed minestrone soup. Oh, the pasta. So, in the evening, I just had a fried egg sandwich. And I think I had toast. Written down extra bread. So, fried egg sandwich with toast. And a couple of glasses of red wine. Which came down to 1,060 calories. Which did exceed the target. But like I said at the start of this video, I've had extra bread today. I've had some red wine because it's Tuesday. It's a treat day. So I'm allowed to. But yeah, so I went over the calorie counts. But that's fine. Wednesday, back to the breakfast. Probably feeling guilty because I know that you're meant to have breakfast on the power plant and I've not done for 2 days. So, black pudding, scrambled eggs, tomatoes, kind of thing that you get out of a tin, it's healthier. And bought sausages. Very, very nice. Which then got me to dinner. I had leftover corned beef hash, which I had jacket spud. And a little bit of butter on there. Not margarine, butter. Far better for it. In the afternoon, once again, it's a feel guilty day. So I went for a banana as a snack. In the evening, I made up a chicken curry. And I wasn't really feeling that hungry, to be honest. So it was just curry with no rice. A bowl of chicken curry. And then finished off with a couple of gin and tonics. Then came to 1,593 calories. All within the target. Thursday breakfast was really a repeat of Wednesday breakfast. Bacon, sausage, fried mushroom, scrambled egg. Like baked beans are more calorific. As good as the tomatoes. No morning snack. But lunchtime I had a chunky vegetable soup. That was followed by chicken curry with couscous. You always get a trend. Probably people notice this is that if you are actually at home cooking, you have a lot of leftovers. I do anyway, so suddenly it's like chicken curry one day, chicken curry and couscous the following day. Always a bit of a giveaway that you're home cooking. So there we go, so chicken curry with couscous. In the afternoon, use an onion crisp. Again, better than flame grilled ones. Otherwise anyway. And then in the evening, it was naked noodle. Chow mein flavour, don't know why, absolutely adore that. With bread, that was 1,743 calories. So on Friday, for breakfast, fried bread, making it again, scrambled egg, and the tomatoes, sausage. No morning snack, I did have a tuna wrap with salad, chicken wing, and some sandwiches, because this is Friday, and as I was saying before, another person's birthday at work, so he'd organised a buffet, and that's where I was having a tuna wrap. I did have salad with it to try and pull up that way. A chicken wing, a couple of sandwiches, avoided burgers, I avoided chips. To be honest with you, that little bit why I had that was absolutely quite filling. Maybe it was just a subconscious thing, and when you're reading the book, it kind of goes through, you know, what your weaknesses are, so maybe subconsciously I look a bit more alert about this. But for me, that is really good for a buffet. No, very little really. I think I might have had two tuna wraps, lots of salad, a couple of chicken wings. Very good. That good, in fact, is I didn't bother with tea because that buffet was quite late. It's about 3 o'clock. So in the evening, just came on Friday night. That's with, and that came to 1,506 calories. Man, God, missed the evening meal. Saturday, back to the nasty ways, no breakfast, no morning snack, just had chili con carne with spaghetti. I am made spaghetti from spaghetti, I actually made it from courgette, which is a good food substitute. It's far lower in calories, it's far better for you, obviously it's a vegetable. And that was followed in the afternoon by Space Raiders beef with bread. So yeah, being from Wigan, I don't know anybody else does this, but 2 pieces of bread, butter it up, crisp in the middle. There's a quick snack. Not the healthiest of snacks, but I am being naughty. And then in the evening, bit of a takeout, so it was a chicken meal, weren't KFC, it was an alternative to KFC. I'd add some fries, chicken fillet, chicken leg, and quavers. All that, probably got a little bit hungry waiting to go for the takeout. Old quavers came out, and then Saturday night a few gin tonics, and that came to 1,544. And then Sunday, the last day, for breakfast, a fried egg sandwich. Probably really enjoyed it the other day, so I just thought, right, another one. So, morning snack, and cheese and onion toasties, back to the bread again. And then, late afternoon, it was sweet and sour popcorn, and a couple of pieces of toast, which means I was probably busy doing something. It was just snacking on popcorn and toast in the afternoon. Then Sunday evening, it was a chip sandwich. I think that, you know, I felt pretty much stuffed probably from all the chicken the day before. Having a chip sandwich or a chip pancake, or med, apart from the bread, and then finished off with gin and tonic. Not too many, you've got the following day. And that came to a wonderful total of 1,268 calories. So, this week with the food, apart from Tuesday, I went over, which I'm allowed to, but all the other days I was actually under, which is very good for me. But looking at the exercise, and once again, target was to hit 10,000 steps. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, I actually exceeded 10,000 steps. And probably contradicts being it a naughty week, but I was thinking naughty week food rather than exercise. And then Saturday and Sunday, it's probably around 5,000-6,000 steps. They become a fail. So there we go, so that's what was eaten, and that was the exercise done for this week. So the next question is, what does the scale say? Could the scales lie? That enough to look a bit weight on, stay the same, or even lose a little bit more weight? Let's have a look. Now, I went back to the spreadsheet, we can see last week was 265 pounds. After being on the scales, the current weight is now 263 pounds. But once again, after being naughty and going to buffets and eating the food that I really, really like, it would seem that I have lost a further 2 pounds. But not as good as the other 2 weeks. It was 4 pounds and 4 pounds. But this week, it is down to 2 pounds, which I think is pretty good. Well, you know, gin and tonics, wine, buffets, takeaways again, and I'm pretty pleased with that. Well, looking at the 2 pound line, and we are still under the line, which is quite good. This is the target, to stay under this line if we can. And considering, you know, I've had salad once, I've had fruit maybe once or twice, the rest of it's been home cooked or pretty much junky food, and I think that's quite a result. So, looking at the smart scales spreadsheet that we've been running, been the weighting for week 3, I think kilograms, of course, it's 120.6 kilograms. I think that's right, because I do not know kilograms. But looking at BMI, we've discovered that drops to 44.3. Looking at the fat, that drops to 39.7, so yeah, still burning external fat, which is brilliant. The muscle came down to 69.9, not too sure why. But you know, that's fine. Water intake had increased now to 47.6, so you are encouraged to drink water when you're on the plan, and this is proof is that that is actually working and your body's holding more water, and hopefully that'll get to an LFA level shortly. Visceral fat has dropped to 33.5. now don't forget, that's the fat around your organs, very, very important to reduce that. We see it's gone down again. Bone mass, 2.75, so once again with the muscles and the bone mass, they've dropped quite a little bit, but not too worried. And then the metabolism dropped to 2130.3, which it will do. If you lose weight, you're going to lose a little bit of metabolism. You're lighter, so there's no effort moving around and doing things. So now looking at the graphs, and weight, BMI, metabolism are all more or less identical. If you lose more weight, they'll come down. Looking at the water, as we've already said, the water increases, and it's increased quite significantly there, and quite in proportion for the other 2 weeks. That's pleasing. The muscle obviously has dipped this week. Once again, I'm not 100% sure why. So I'm sure that will gain back shortly. Maybe at the weekend, it was an extremely lazy weekend or something, and they're away on a Monday. Maybe they had a chance to kick back in. but bone mass is steadily going down almost to the same level as the weight itself. That's looking quite healthy. Then we have fat, which is reduced, which is your external fat and your visceral fat. But once again, if we look at visceral fat versus fat, we can see is that the visceral fat looks like it's coming off quicker. Which, you know, for the mark of any plant or diet, if you can reduce the visceral fat and the fat, that is an absolute win-win. So looking at this, once again, everything seems to be going back into the right direction. It's excellent news, and it basically shows that the plan works, even if you don't follow it to the letter or so. Well, there we go, so we have it. So, £2 off, the fat coming off, brilliant. The metabolism being reduced, that's fine. If you're losing weight, metabolism. Everything's looking good, apart from the bone mass, which is fair enough, yeah. Everything's looking good apart from the bone mass. Not too sure why. I lost a little bit this week, and the muscle mass. But we'll see what happens next week. Probably just a little. Yeah, not done as much. I've thought 3,000 steps, just sat there chilling, watching TV or something. After all, it is a naughty week. But there we go. So join us next week for week 4. Hopefully we can get these videos out a little bit quicker. We've got weeks 4, 5 and 6 left to have a look at. And our conclusion. And other videos to look forward to as well coming then. So thank you very much for joining me. I hope you found it as interesting as what I've done. And we'll see you soon.
If you have enjoyed this video, then please provide your support by liking this video and subscribing to this YouTube channel. If you are watching on Facebook, then please like and share this video with your family and friends. And as always, thank you for viewing.